Welcome back to, hopefully, fingers crossed, the final episode of Sherlock Holmes vs. Arsene Lupin. If that's the case, I will be greatly appreciative because, I mean, it's, I don't have to worry about not having this game finished over the summer, and also, a plus, I can work on adding more content, maybe get one more Let's Play out before I can't record anymore. We'll have to see. It'll have to be a short one, though, because I don't have terribly much time left alone. So, we are here at the dormitory, and we are about to break into this room right here using the key. And what we find here? We find... There should be, I think. Memory serves, there should be...
It must be the guard's cloakroom.
Not that, but, I was expecting this. Meanwhile...
Well, Lupin is certainly making us wait. It's already been 4 hours that...
Enough, Lestrade, enough. I know how to count.
Listen. Shh.
What?
I hear a noise. Like a motor. A small motor.
Well, you have a good ear, because I don't hear anything with this cursed tick-tock.
Shh. Keep quiet. There is a strange noise, I tell you.
It's true. It's behind the door. Quick, Lestrade, it's him.
It's Lupin. What can he be up to?
Watch out! I'm going to open the door. I'll see...
So, Inspector?
What are you doing? Wake up, you lot of bunglers! It was nothing, just the snores of the men on duty.
Bravo, Lestrade! You keep your men in line.
You ought to congratulate Dr. Watson. A bit more, and it would have been the longest police hideout of all time.
Calm, gentlemen. Calm. Lupin won't be long now.
Yeah, you can keep telling yourself that. Lupin's never showing up. Meanwhile, back at the game! Oh, gosh. I think I remember this place. Wait, what's this?
This is, without a doubt, a freshly combed moustache hair.
Lupin, I'll bet. A little vain, aren't you? I wouldn't be this vain if I was about to try and commit the crime of the century, or whatever. Anyway... So, let's see. It says, look at... What's this, actually? Sergeant, I'm leaving this to ask you if you wouldn't want to change the lockers with me. Okay, and we also have this right here. The guards rotation for the month. And it opens a puzzle. Interesting how it does it on the map screen. So, let's just go ahead and put the lockers together. Alright, so let's begin with number one. Which is... No, sorry, not dragons. Oh, Shia. Followed by Willoughby, Moore, Hickman, Bell, Schick, what kind of name is that? Well, this is England, so well. Johnson, Summerby, Jesus, there's lovely names. Jones, there's a normal name finally. Law. Okay, I guess they keep the law, the book of the law in that one. Mortson. Styles. Kirkpatrick. March of the Surviving Youth. Ludlow and Flint.
Elementary.
Now what? Number 13. Am I supposed to do something in-game? So I just watch these little check marks rotate. That's kind of a cool detail. Well, hopefully... Is
This door is solid, the lock is rather ancient, and each locker has a different lock. If I want to open one in particular, the chance of finding a key within a reasonable amount of time is almost null. I will have to use force. Blow up the lock, perhaps?
Yes, let's blow up a lock. That won't attract attention. Hang on. It says go to the cook's apartment. Oh, we were already there, so we're ahead. So... let's build a bomb. Alright, so it says here in the inventory... hang on. There's a nutcracker and cartridges to get gunpowder. Right, we got that. Gunpowder and strength. And hang on, I messed this up once. Let's do it again. Let's place on the lock. It says.
I will have enough gunpowder to blast open one locker. I must be sure of which one.
What?
This door is solid. This door is solid.
I get it. I didn't even read what... what did he say? Oh, matches. Okay. I was looking down and so I didn't hear him. Wasn't paying attention. Alright, so what's inside?
Open.
What the heck is this?
This haggis is fresh and supple. Perhaps it is meant for the cook in order to prepare a special dish. Not appetizing, but I am taking it regardless.
And a key!
This must be the key to the storeroom.
I can just walk there, so I'm not gonna bother trying to jump. Yeah, right. Come on. Come on, move it. What was that right there? Like a little thing popped up all of a sudden. This is the way to the storeroom, right? Please tell me it is. Yep, there it is over there. Come on.
Closed.
Oh, right. Use the key. And something here. Nope, okay. So, why we need to be in storeroom? Because there's a dude lost
Smith
in there.
He looks to be unconscious. Is there a chance of waking him up?
Maybe can we go in here? No, we can't. Wait, hang on.
The lock of the grill has been changed, and I can no longer open it.
Well, dang it! Well, I guess there's one thing we can do. Go in the first person, because it'd be a little easier to find this way. Is that here? Game said look for a bucket. Well, there's a bucket right there, but, no, that can't be right. There it is.
Water.
Thank you.
That's it. Hickman fell asleep quite gradually, probably under the effect of a strong narcotic. The prints on the ground in front of the storeroom made me think that Smith was knocked out and not drugged. Thus, only a bit of cold water was necessary to awaken him.
Smith, wake up. Do you hear me, Smith? It's Holmes.
My head. What's going on? What am I doing here? Mr. Holmes? Where is the doctor?
Listen, Smith. Pull yourselves together and come here. Can you open this grill?
My keychain has disappeared. No, I can't open it. After you came through the other day, the cook insisted on changing the lock. It now needs a key.
Fine. In that case, I'll need your help. We'll need to find a way to get you out of there. Foremost, you must precisely recount the events of the night. And who is the doctor you speak of?
Well, early in the afternoon, The few men who were still present in the rampart were taken sick, with awful stomach aches. Must have been something in yesterday's meal. I don't digest tomatoes well, so I didn't eat, and I felt fine. Our usual doctor was absent, so I had to call a doctor in the area, Dr. Sernin. He hasn't been around for long, but I've heard good things about him. In examining the first man, he appeared alarmed and insisted on treating them with injections. We checked on all of the guards and he treated them all. The last to be treated was Hickman. The doctor was vexed as he didn't have enough medication to administer a full dose, but he assured me it would be enough. Afterwards, he asked if we had seen all of the men in the garrison, which was affirmative. He asked me to accompany him to the postern, and I had hardly turned when I felt a sharp pain at the base of my head. I don't remember anything else.
Well, isn't that just peachy? Well, the answer is obviously Arsène Lupin.
I am beginning to see. What medication did he administer?
I really don't know. An empty vial fell into a puddle, and I picked it up.
The label is damaged, and the water would have washed out any remaining substance. Impossible to tell what it held.
But what are you doing here? Can you explain what's going on?
I assume that the guards who are watching the crown jewels were also attended to.
Yes, and the only key leading to that room is on my chain.
I must help you out of here. Is there another key to this grill?
The cook has one, but he's out. However, I think I had a spare key to the guard room made, and it wasn't on my chain. You might just find something there that will get me out of here, or capture the person responsible for all of this.
All right, so you got a key and a bottle of Wajamahoozies. Okay, it's just a form's flask. So let us jump to the, I guess this place, the Iron Tower. Because we need to go to the weapons room. And this is the closest place that I can think of to it. The guide says something else, but there's nothing by that name here. I'm assuming this game, this walkthrough is made for the original version of the game, and I'm playing the remastered edition. And boy, am I glad I am, because I don't think I can stand the first-personness for the entire game.
Closed.
What do you mean, closed? Ugh. Open sesame! And now we have our jump point again. Thank goodness. So, we made it to the weapons room. And let's see here. Let's go here. In the store. Again. Take the key.
Look, this warder must have lost this key in falling. What could it be for?
I don't know, a door maybe?
If I am to believe the tag on his uniform, this warder is called Summerby. Apparently he was also taken care of by the doctor. Dr. Lupin.
Dr. Lupin? Never go to him.
It's the door of the Queen's Jewel House, and it is quite solid. Was that the sound of a saw from behind the door? Lupin could be finished in his work any moment. I must make haste.
Alrighty. So, let me see here. Game says, in my game I mean my walkthrough. Yeah, there's a bunch of stuff we need to go grab around here now to begin the final
scrap. This served to store the exact quantity of powder necessary to load the cannon.
That over here, yes, many lovely things.
Small dry pieces of wood.
And nothing here.
This liquid has a strong smell. Certainly a petrol derivative to lubricate or clean metal. There isn't much left, just enough to moisten a rag.
Perhaps I'd be able to find something useful in this case, but it is locked.
Oh, good grief! Open it, please.
Which may prove to be useful.
And?
Which may prove to be useful.
And? That's all. Haha, that's kind of funny doing that. Alrighty, so...
Magnificent articulated armor.
I don't care. Let's see, is there anything else? Just check. Oh, I missed something right here.
This dish is empty, but might work.
Oh, there's what I wanted.
This helmet stand is quite singular, sturdy and very light.
I don't know why the match is equipped, dude. Maybe a key I hit by accident when I was trying to hit space did it. I think that's everything, so let's stop wasting our time going zippity-doo-da, zippity-day. I am Sherlock Holmes. Whoa. Camera kind of spazzed out right there. Alrighty, so, do we have everything we need? That's a lot of junk, so I'm gonna assume yes. Alright. Oh wait, no, not in here, to the cannon at the back wall.
A small navy cannon.
Alright, so, let's see here. Oh, we need to go to the storeroom. All right, take your file, you old man.
Take this file, it's all that I could find. Is there any way to enter the jewel house without a key?
No, not without a cannon at least.
In that case, I'll have to find one.
You are kidding, I'm sure.
I would not trifle with such a serious matter as this.
The munitions are found in the armory at the top of the staircase heading to the White Tower, the central tower. Apart from the one on my keychain, the other key is found in one of the service buildings. And it will be far too complicated to tell you how to locate it.
Pray, release yourself as quickly as possible. Go find the key and open the door of the armory for me. I will join you there. Is that your scarf over there? Can you please pass it to me?
My daughter just finished knitting it.
She should start knitting another, because before entering the jewel house, I must block Lupin's retreat.
Alrighty, so... So, it looks like it's time to begin building the hot air balloon to block Lupin's retreat, so... Here we are, here... Actually, I probably could have done a closer location, but, I decided not to, for... I don't know why. So, let us walk to the edge of the world as we know it! Yeah, I probably should have jumped to the weapons room, but oh well. Now we just get to walk... Walk all day. Stop! Alright, here we are. Right under the rope. So, let us build a hot air balloon. How we build hot air balloon. So, in the inventory, we want to combine the helmet stand. Where is the helmet stand? With... Need to do helmet stand with the haggis.
I found it. I will make two hot air balloons.
I must burn the rope that Lupin strung between the jewel house and the exterior. Otherwise, he will escape that way. Quickly, time is pressing.
Now the lampshade with the wax doily. That's two. Now combine the dish with the string. And the cake, oh, that's, there's two. I did the cake mold by accident first. Combine the bowl with the string with the hot air balloon. That one apparently, and then this one.
Now
that
I must
one.
Find some fuel for my hot air balloons.
How about some wood? Perfect. And is that all? I need to use the oil. Okay. Now that that is done, use some oil. Use the scarf on each. And combine the two hot air balloons.
I must release my hot air balloons in precise order.
Alright, so let's see. Can we do it now? Looks like we can.
I must burn the rope that Lupin strung between the jewel house and the exterior. Otherwise, he will escape that way. Quickly, time is pressing. I will ignite my balloons as soon as I release them. Watch out, they're off.
There they go.
The rope must have been somewhat damaged to no longer be able to support a heavy load. Let's see if Smith has been able to get out and find the key to the arsenal.
Alright, so jump to the central place, the White Tower. Ah, here he is.
I've been working as quickly as I could, but my old arms have been shaking like leaves with the effort.
While I am taking care of the robber, we'll need to get to the base of Big Ben in order to find one of the officers thereabouts, because I don't think you'll find another in the whole of London.
But what are they doing there?
You don't want to know. No, no, no. Meanwhile, again.
Enough already. Enough.
Prime Minister, I...
Where is he then, this Lupin? Does he think I have nothing better to do?
I've just done my round. You wouldn't believe, but there's a mob of journalists down there.
Well, that takes the biscuit.
It's not surprising. Half the force has been kicking their heels in front of Big Ben for the past 8 hours. It couldn't go unnoticed forever.
Journalists? A mob? Yes, but of course.
What now, Doctor?
Inspector, check the identities of the journalists. Lupin has previously disguised as a journalist, and I am sure it was he who alerted them in order to create a diversion and slip in.
Well played, Doctor. I'm on it. At last, some action.
Lupin has previously disguised himself as a journalist, did you say? When was this, then, Doctor?
Ah, well,
Well, that's just splendid. Back to reality. By reality, I mean what should be reality. Hang on. Hey, we just ran a circle. Oh, that's the door. Okay, don't go to the door. I thought that was something important.
This may prove to be useful.
There it is.
Oh, yes. One of these glasses, which resembles those in a chemist's laboratory, reads 2.8 ounces. The other gratings have been erased.
Whoa! Lots of stuff. Memory serves. We actually have to be correct. Let me check and make sure we got something. Yep, that's what we wanted. And, let's see here. A 2.5 diameter ball.
These cannonballs have a diameter.
Nope.
These cannonballs
nope.
have a diameter. These cannonballs have a
here
diameter.
Here we go.
These cannonballs are very heavy. I can only take one at a time.
Good thing we got the right one the first time. And let's see, we need a small barrel of powder. Powder. Taker!
A small barrel of powder.
Okay, so we got that. Now we need to go to the Queen's house, and I bet you know anything there. Or not the Queen's house, the door. Oh, here's the jump pump for the dormitory. Figured out finally. Then we get the kids' roller skates. Take them, please.
Certainly a gift for a child. Roller skates.
Oh, it wasn't take roller skates? Really? Oh, use the screwdriver on... Okay, that's different.
This may prove to be useful.
Let's see, now what? Ah, time for some action to the weapons room. What do we do here? It's time to load the cannon. Right?
This cannon is heavy, but I will be able to push it. I'll need to find a way to move it to the front of the door of the Queen's Jewel House.
Well. How about we get this? Some wheels.
This cannon is heavy.
Hang on, wait a minute. Wait. Oh, okay, so let's see. Hang on, did I miss something? Dang, I think that was something that I missed here. Ugh! Hang on, let me go back to the White Tower real quickly. There it is.
This thick cover could support a very heavy load.
Alright, let's do that. Boom, baby! We're making progress! Alright, finally, now then. Now that that's done, now we can make progress, finally. Maybe we thank God. Aha. Let us make progress. Finally. Thank God. No, not, we're not gonna burn the cannon!
Now I can push it to the door of the Jewel House.
Oh, push it, by all means.
The stairs are preventing me from getting past. How can I mount them with my artillery?
Well, let us see. How do we mount them with the artillery? By... Oh, we... It's kind of funny, actually. We steal the door!
There, the door's dismantled. Now, I must find the appropriate location where I should place it.
Well, how about right here?
I need something.
Oh, well, fine, get the door. Where's the door? I'll pick it up first.
There, the door is dismantled. Now, I must find the appropriate location where I should place it.
Right here.
Elementary.
Now, up you go! Whee! That's kind of fun.
There. Now I am in firing position, and there's nothing more to do but load this cannon.
Alright.
I must decant the proper amount of powder into this receptacle, and pour it into the cannon.
Alrighty, so... Let's do this. Alright, let's see here. So, add 250 things to the bag. Just follow my lead, because it will cost a few steps to this. What's it mean by that? Hang on. I doubt it. Alright, I'm gonna do this the other way, because that way it seemed to fail. Oh, because it needed 470. Oh, wait, hang on, let me try something. Maybe I almost had it. Try one more time. I think I got this. Alright, so 250. Yeah. Whoops. 80. 80 there. Another of that. And then 90. Track? That's kind of a dumb design. Alrighty. Well, let's try it this way. That and then 1, 2, 3, 4, 18, 19. There we go. Where's the cannon?
There. Now I am in firing position, and there's nothing more to do but load this cannon. I need something.
Alright, fine.
There. Now I am in... I need something.
Alright, now I've done that. A full cannon part. There we go.
Elementary.
Cannonball.
Elementary.
Gunpowder.
There. Now I am in...
I need something. Light up the sky! Music. As fun as classical we can get, at least.
If I were you, Lupin, I wouldn't take that path. As you can surmise by the plumes of smoke emanating from the rope originating from this window, it, let's say, suffered by my hand, and there is no chance that it will support your weight nor the items that I imagine you to be carrying.
You impress me, Mr. Holmes. You see, I concocted this plan with such thoroughness and... I'm sure you'll agree, a fair amount of genius, such that I was saddened that none would see it as I brought it to fruition. And yet, there you were from the first. A bit too close for comfort, wasn't it? And if you are here, it's because you must have searched, and most certainly found, all of the parts of the puzzle, down to the smallest detail. And I can't but congratulate you on your performance. I am a gentleman, Mr. Holmes. And even if I didn't always show good sportsmanship during this adventure, my sense of honor obliges me to acknowledge your victory tonight. As someone who never knew defeat before meeting you, I would like to express my admiration and how honored I am that you not only played this game with me, but won also.
You should, Monsieur Lupin, understand that I share your admiration and know that if you're giving me the honor of the victory tonight, it was yours the last four times.
Your intelligence has no equal apart from your sense of chivalry, Mr. Holmes. You know as well as I do, those were but a few minor obstructions, and whoever wins the final battle takes the war.
Despite everything, our camp suffered some losses, the gravity of which could have been fatal if they had been made public. No one, myself included, would have come out of a Pyrrhic victory unscathed.
I betrayed myself by doing anything that could have harmed your reputation. I am duty-bound to you, Mr. Holmes, and I will accept your conditions, even if they dishonor me. As long as they don't dishonor my country.
You managed, thanks to your remarkable intelligence, to deny me any margin of maneuverability to decide in advance should we find ourselves in the situation in which we are. It was a chess match, and there is nothing remaining on the table but the two kings. This is a classic stalemate, wouldn't you agree?
You will find at this address a master's painting, a great rock, and a few birds. As for what Her Majesty wished for me, I had no choice but to give it to her at that very instant. Once again, I am at a loss for words to express the pleasure that I took from this adventure with you. Even if it costs me, I promise, on my honor, that I will never publicize the account of what took place.
We shall not meet again, my friend, but know that during the past few days, your presence in our soil did as much honor to your country as ours. Safe journey, Monsieur Lupin.
What? You'll let him leave like that?
What choice did I have, Watson? Look at the whole picture. Lupin's real intent was to steal the crown jewels. The goal of all the other thefts was to provide a sort of insurance in the case of failure, and, above all, to ensure the services of a plethora of accomplices. Us.
Us? Accomplices? I admit that I was fooled once, but I didn't steal anything.
From the moment we read Lupin's first letter, we became his accomplices. In fact, by having us play his game, Lupin was conditioning us. After the first theft, he left clues leading us to the second, from the second to the third. So well that as the second to last theft, we were convinced that Lupin's final target would be Big Ben. Lupin knew that the authorities, headed by the Prime Minister himself, would align themselves with the only person who could sort out Lupin's schemes as they happened, myself. Therefore, in controlling me, he was controlling all of London's police force, and he nearly succeeded.
Then why not simply steal the jewels to begin with? Why this whole masquerade?
I've just explained it, Watson. In order to steal the crown jewels, Lupin had to accomplish certain preliminaries. In the first place, he had to be assured that the garrison would be only minimally guarded on the night of the theft. Therefore, he started using a disguise, of course, by getting rid of the garrison's usual doctor, by giving him a free trip to the continent. He also befriended the cook under another identity while the cook was out on the town. Thus, he was able to suggest a specific recipe for a specific date, the eve of the jewel theft. Then he went to nab the ravens. The effects of this theft permitted him to first create an inauspicious event that forced reduction in the size of the garrison so that the news wouldn't spread. Second, to have access to the storeroom in order to poison the tomatoes that were going to be used in the recipe that he gave to the cook. Third, to pose as Paul Selim, that doctor who would be called in the case of emergency. Fourth, given that a theft had already taken place at the Tower of London, we would have had to have bats in the belfry to think that there would be another. Lupin also needed to get the police out of the area, which happened as I already explained.
I understand, but what of the other thefts?
A part of the process of conditioning, they caused us to put little weight on the theft in the Tower of London. If that had been the only prelude, we would have taken more time to ponder the clues and find Lupin's true intentions. Yet this time he didn't leave it up to us. And so, like I told you, these thefts were his insurance. Lupin had beaten us four times on the battlefield of English honor, such as he had suggested to us in his letter. Our pride in not bringing our defeats public was our sin, and it made us prisoners of his game. If he had proven beaten, he could have profited from the restitution of the objects, the price of his silence regarding our failures, and the true value of our police. A discreet release was a small price to pay with regards to an affront of international scope. Do not forget that the Queen herself is implicated.
Indeed. It is, moreover, a matter of conscience for me. When I write this adventure, I do not think I...
But there's no question, Watson. You cannot write about it. You promised before God that you wouldn't.
But Holmes...
Your word is your bond. In any case, you wouldn't want to relate the ignoble theft that you committed, that of my Order of the Legion of Honor.
Holmes, you know that.
It's in the past, Watson. It's in the past. Incidentally, a young woman came by to return it a few moments ago. She wanted to deliver it to you directly. She seemed to know you well. A young woman who can be found at the Golden Lion, am I right? She doesn't seem like your usual client, unless, of course, you were the client in this case. What do you say, Watson?
I say that was Sherlock Holmes versus Arsene Lupin. I suppose I should put remastered in the title of the videos, but that means I have to go through and change all other 11 episodes which are already uploaded and scheduled for release in 2 months. So I'm going to say forget it. I'll just leave it as titled. So now we just watch the insufferably slow credits. As I say, I really enjoyed playing this game. And, completing it in a rather timely manner. This is episode 13, I believe. Well, it's really, it's gonna be titled the finale, but I think we did in 13 episodes. 14 if I decide to be a jerk and divide this recording session up. Which I might do, we'll have to see how I feel. Yeah, so. Coming up next, probably, well, I can't say probably, it means I have to figure out what is next. Because this is going to be out before, this is going to be complete before June is over. So I've got 2 months of content. You have to figure out how to fill. Good goshness. That's going to be interesting. We'll probably take a week hiatus to give me time to figure out how. But who knows what I'll do next. Probably not an adventure game because that would take a lot of recording time to complete. Because this game was over 10 hours long, I think. I don't know. So let's do a little bit of math. So each episode has been, give or take, 30 minutes. There are, goodness, where's my calculator? Oh, well, I'll use my cell phone. Okay, here. So, each episode is about 30 minutes. We have 13 episodes. So that's 390 minutes. Divide that by 60 minutes. You got, okay, that's a lot shorter than I thought. We did in about roughly 6.5 hours. So how about that? 6.5 hours of content. So I don't know what I'm gonna do next. Well, Plan B is actually next. You'll find out what Plan B is probably in a week or so. And then after that, I'll have to find. We'll probably finish recording. Well, now that this is, I can throw all my focus in the game Plan B, like more. Worked on because it could use a few more episodes, and then maybe I don't know what I'll do after that. I have a leaning towards playing Siberia, but I don't know. That's another long game, and I don't think I can have it completed before. Heck, I haven't completed it my own run yet, so there's that. Well, at long last, after several months of working on this project, I can successfully close this tab on my iPad because I no longer need that walkthrough. Until I decide to come back and play this game again, which may very well happen one day. But for now, that is all for Sherlock Holmes vs. Arsene Lupin. Thank you so much for watching. If you like this Let's Play, be sure to leave a comment and a like down below and subscribe for more videos. And I will see you in my emergency plan B.